Hi everyone, Powell eased rising inflation worries, but today's PPI data could actually revive those worries yet again. Gold is about to reverse its medium-term bearish trend, and we discuss in this episode the potential in the Beyond Meat play. Now, major US indices rallied on Thursday after the Federal Reserve Chair Jerome Powell showed he is more concerned with the rising COVID cases than the rising inflation expectations right now, and that despite some parts of the economy doing great, because there is a very large group of people who are not, he said. And as long as the American economy, especially the US jobs market, is not doing great again, the Fed is here to give a hand. As such, Powell's commitment to the ultra supportive monetary policy stance, regardless of the rising inflation worries, isn't only boosting the US jobs market, but continues boosting the US stock markets as well. Now, it's true it took some time, but Powell is now doing a great job in taming the beast at the market. His dovish stance goes through, the US yields are under control, and the risk appetite is here, yet it's still a little bit fragile, because due today, the US producer price inflation could again revive the worries of seeing an overshoot in the US inflation, as the headline PPI figure is expected to have shot up to 3.8% year on year in March from 2.8% printed a month earlier, mostly due to higher energy costs and global chip shortage. Now, whether investors will remember Powell's yesterday words that the overshoot in consumer price inflation should not last long depends on the strength of the data, really. Panic of seeing a too strong PPI figure could actually brush aside the Fed does before the weekly closing bell, although investors know that any loss of appetite in the US stock markets would remain short-lived. Now, looking at the market, the S&P 500 hit a new all-time record as Nasdaq closed 1% higher yesterday. Gold, the safe haven, advances along with the risk assets these days, as the combination of stable US yields and rising inflation expectations offer a favorable setting for the non-interest-bearing gold investments. We see bulls and bears are fighting a fierce battle a touch below the 50-day moving average, which stands near $1,760 per ounce, if clear, should reverse the midterm negative trend in gold and push the price of an ounce within the $1,780-$1,800 range. Now, looking at the tech stocks, they are doing fine as well, as the reflation theme is momentarily pushed aside on the back of the rising COVID worries and the dovish Fed expectations. Apple rallied near 2% yesterday as Microsoft added 1.34%. Now, a quick dive in Netflix, which gained 1.39% on news that Sony Pictures will stream all movies exclusively on Netflix from next year. Spider-Man and Jumanji franchises are also included in this deal, which actually increases the Netflix offer to a larger and more exciting palette, and could boost subscriptions moving forward. This is good news for Netflix as COVID also continues nailing millions at home, and the vaccination efforts seem to help a little bit, but not as much or as fast as hoped. The COVID cases mount worldwide. China is apparently running into a vaccine shortage as well, and may not reach its goal of giving a shot to the 40% of its population by June. While the drama around the AstraZeneca vaccine is not over just yet, there are news now that people less than a certain age should not receive the shot, which actually means that taking the risk of having a blood clot due to the vaccine is not necessarily worth the benefit for the youngest. On the other hand, authorities in Europe recognize the correlation between the AstraZeneca vaccine and the formation of blood clots, but they continue campaigning in favor of receiving a shot anyway, as the benefits of receiving the vaccine are higher than the risks on individual and on collective perspective. Still, in some places like in France, AstraZeneca vaccines remain refused even in the absence of alternatives, and no one can blame people for refusing this AstraZeneca shot. So with all this drama going on, obviously AstraZeneca shares are back to their March levels, but remain well above the pre-pandemic range. range still. So I believe there is a room for a further downside correction, although the blood cut issue should not eat into all AstraZeneca profits moving forward. So investors and patients have pretty much the same dilemma right now of trusting AstraZeneca despite the known risk, because the overall situation is so not brilliant and the scarcity of doses gives a chance to a less than ideal solution. So buying AstraZeneca shares at a discounted price could be attractive for some investors, yet I'm not convinced it's the healthiest take, it's the healthiest alternative. Now, moving away from all the vaccine drama, I also question whether investors who go so fiercely beyond full are also ready to go beyond meat. Beyond meat shares saw a quick boost after the company announced to expand its production somewhere near Shanghai to attack the Asian market recently. So Beyond Meat is a concept that actually seems to work in the US, the country where the meat consumption is so huge that replacing meat with a substitute, a plant-based meat, makes sense. But there is just one thing that bothers me in this entire story, and it looks like it doesn't bother only me. It's not because it's plant-based that it's necessarily healthy. No, I believe that your plant-based steak remains a super transformed product, and it does not replace the steamed broccoli on your plate. I'm sorry. So I'm not sure that Asians who have a diet that includes a lot of real vegetables and a small serving of meat only is the right market for Beyond Meat, but it's worth a try. Now, Beyond Meat made great deals with PepsiCo, McDonald's, and Yum! Brands, including KFC, Pizza Hut, and Taco Bell, to offer plant-based menus to these customers. But you would agree that all these brands are not healthy diet alternatives in the first place. So what Beyond Meat is doing right now is to associate itself with famous brands, yes, but these brands are not famous for being anything healthy. So offering a healthier option, a healthier alternative to a super unhealthy segment is good, but it's not great. Anyway, looking at the share price, we actually see that there are attempts to push the price of Beyond Meat higher, but these attempts are often followed by sizable downside corrections as investors seem to see opportunity in shorting the stock as the price goes too high. For now, we are near the bottom range of 2020, so there is a possibility for short-term buyers to make some profit on tactical long positions, but I wouldn't place my target price too high, as beyond skepticism, there's also the pressure of competition that is preparing to enter the fake meat market. So according to the latest news, Impossible Foods, so which is another company which offers substitute for meat products, is preparing a $10 billion IPO within the next 12 months, or a merger with a SPAC, you know, that famous special purpose acquisition companies that became just so famous for being an alternative to the traditional IPOs these days. Now, globally speaking, should you buy SPAC? Well, it really depends on your risk appetite, on your risk tolerance. Some companies, including Playboy and DraftKings, for example, were taken public through an SPAC, so it was successful, while many of such deals flopped. So it's risky but interesting. And speaking of the DraftKings, our famous Cathie Wood added more DraftKings shares in her portfolio apparently recently, and other companies active in sports betting such as Penn National Gaming rallied recently on New York's plans to allow these sport gambling companies to finance their state's deficit. So there could be an opportunity out there. Indeed, your DraftKings shares could have an important upside potential on the back of this regulation change in New York, in case you want to follow Cathie Wood on her investment decision. Now, a final word in Bitcoin before the weekend. It looks like Bitcoin rally is losing steam, a touch below the $60,000 mark. I already mentioned that the fact that the latest peak that we've seen in the price remained lower than the previous is a sign of sputtering, and we could see a further downside correction in Bitcoin prices. The $55,000 support area is important. Slipping below this level could accelerate the sell-off in Bitcoin, as the loss of momentum combined to the reality that the price of a coin went just too high in a too short period of time calls for correction, and a rapid downside correction could leave many of Bitcoin bulls on their back foot. This is all for this week. I'm Ipek Ozkardeskaya, and thank you for joining me. I hope this episode of Market Talk has been helpful and insightful to you. Please do not hesitate to follow us on Twitter and on LinkedIn for regular market updates, and subscribe to our YouTube channel for daily market comments. I see you again next week, and until then, good day trading and have a nice weekend.